So we're going to talk about solving percent problems. So in this video, we're going to talk about solving percent problems. In this video, we're going to talk about how to solve percent problems. So we have to remember what percent is. The word percent is short for percentum. We use this percent symbol to represent percent, and it actually means per 100. And so, for example, if we have 2%, this is the same thing as 2 per 100. Well, we can think about this 2% not just as 2 per 100, we can think about it as a ratio, 2 per 100. And then if we take this ratio or fraction and rewrite it as a decimal, this is 2 hundredths, which is the same thing as 0.02. So 2% is the same, represents the same amount as 0.02. That percent is per 100. So the whole or the denominator of your fraction is 100, and the top represents the part that you have. So another way we can think of percent as the number is the amount of parts that you have, and the percent is it takes 100 to make a whole. So if we think about percent, how do you find 50% of 200? So I want to find 50% of 200. Well, 50% we can write as 50 per 100. And we want to know, which is the same thing, if we reduce the fraction as half to a half. And we want to know 50% of 100. Well, in math, the word of actually tells us to multiply. So we're going to take that 50% and multiply it by 200. So we want half of 200. That's what 50% is the same as a half. So when you multiply this out, we get 100. So 50% of 200 is 100. So a more formal type of problem that you might have something like 25 is 50% of what number? Well, there are a couple of ways you can go about solving this. The first way is to translate this sentence into an equation. So the word 25 is just 25. Is the same thing as an equal sign. 50%, well, that's 50%. Of what number? Of tells us to multiply. And then what number? Well, that's what we're trying to find out. We're going to call that x. So 25 is 50% of what number? So now we're going to solve this. Well, 50%, this is a little weird to work with it with this percent symbol. So we're going to rewrite it. You can either rewrite it as a fraction or as a decimal. I'm going to rewrite it as a decimal, as 0.50 or 0.5. Okay, So I have 25 equals 0.5x. Now all I have to do is solve for x, which means I just divide by 0.5. And so I get 5 goes into 25, or 0.5 goes into 25, we get 50, and then on the other side we get x. So our number is 50. The other way you could solve this is with, so this is the first way. The second way, there's a second way you can solve these problems, is with a proportion. So this 50% is 50 per 100, and we want a ratio that's equivalent to that, that has 25 is the part, and the what number is the whole. So now we just have to solve this proportion. So we end up with, we got to multiply on both sides by x, multiply on both sides by x. Actually, we want 100x to cancel out the 100 on this side. So the 100s cancel over here, the x's cancel over here, and we get 50x equals 2500, and then we divide by 50, we get x equals 50. And that's it, we're done. So you can solve these types of, these percent problems either way, either setting it up as an equation or using a proportion, up to you. Whatever works best for you. So another type of problem you could encounter, or another example of a problem you might encounter. So we have 14 is what percent of 140? So in this problem, we're looking for the percent rather than the whole or the amount. So we can set it up again either as an equation or a proportion, and I'll show you both ways. So let's set it up in an equation first. So 14 just translates to 14. The is always an equal sign. And then what percent? So that's what we're looking for. So we'll call that x. And then we're going to multiply that by 140. Okay. So we just have to solve this for x. So to do that, we divide both sides by 140. All right. And so when we divide 140 into 14, we get 10, and on the other side we just are left with x. So what 14 is what percent of 140? It's 10%. That would be your answer. All right. Well, the other way we can do it, again, we can set it up as a proportion. So to set it up as a proportion, so that's the equation way, this is the proportion way. So if we want to set up as a proportion, 14 is the part, and 140 is the whole, right, in our problem. And then we know that the whole for the percent is 100, and what we're looking for is the part. So we've got our proportion set up, and so we just have to multiply both sides by 100 to get the x by itself, right? So they cancel out over here, leaving us with x on this side, and then when we multiply 100, or we reduce this fraction and multiply, you're going to get 10. So again, we get the same answer of 10%. And so that's just another example of a type of percent problem that you might encounter.